can't find anything we want to watch. What do you suggest?
I don't know. What you think? Well, this is a really great movie. I have a last copy.
Thanks.
Hey, we're back.
Hey,
back.
Did y'all get anything?
Yeah, Gary's coming with it.
Oh, okay.
Hey, here's something to watch. We go in the video store, so this is great.
Okay, let's try it.
As you meet your teachers and become involved in your child's school life.
What is the wildest excuse you've ever had for not having your homework?
My dog ate it.
My mom left town and she wasn't there to help me out with it.
The wildest excuse I ever had, my grandma spilled snuff on my homework.
My computer ate it.
Well, my dog's girlfriend died, and he was all upset, so I said, well, I just won't do my homework, and so I comfort him.
What homework?
Hey, homework.
Do we have homework?
We have homework.
We have homework.
We have homework.
I didn't do it. I don't need an excuse. I always do my homework.
I simply don't know.
My biggest excuse for not doing my homework is my aunt died, and I was so sorry.
My neighbor's house burned down, right? And I had to run in and save him, right? And while I was there, I had my homework in my hand, and it burned.
It's in my locker, and do you want me to go get it?
I didn't feel like it.
My dog ate it.
And it was in my back pocket, and it fell in the toilet, and I flushed it.
Then I made it into a paper airplane, and it was hijacked to Cuba.
What's the wildest excuse you've ever given for not having your homework?
Well, I was going to do it, but I didn't know how, so I just...
Would you describe Western student?
Bright, energetic, helpful.
I think we have some very good students here at Western, and also we have some very bright students here.
Hey, Western students are fun, loving, caring, laid-back students to me.
Today, my idea of the typical student is depressed.
Today, the typical student is overworked.
Overwhelmed.
They're social.
Typical student is someone that I love and the reason that I'm here.
Fascinating.
Well-mannered.
Typical student to me is one who asks lots and lots and lots of questions.
Well, today my students were excited because we started something new.
Oh, hey, I'm talking to the typical student at Western High School. I think the typical student is conscientious, creative, and a real joy to be around.
Well, I think that depends on the particular day that you're involved with them. Some days they can be fun-loving and caring, and other days they just don't care at all.
Beautiful.
Los estudiantes de Western High School son los más macanudos y chéveres del mundo.
I've been involved with a lot of students in Alamance County, and Western students are definitely the best.
I got some.
Sweetheart, if you weren't in school, where would you be? Probably in Hollywood making a video for CoverGirl. Thank you.
At home asleep.
I'd rather be hunting, you know. I'd kill me a big old deer.
At home, combing my hair. So it look funky fresh, you know what I'm saying?
Shopping.
Where would you like to be, Christy, if you weren't in school?
On a yacht in the Virgin Islands.
At home.
At Jamie's house.
I like to be at Richie Jones' house.
I'm probably making money.
I would like to be in California soaking up the sun, laying on the beach.
With Charlotte, I guess.
I'd probably like to be at home in front of TV.
Where else would you like to be?
Ron's house.
If you weren't in school today, where would you like to be?
I'd like to be in the North Pole helping Santa. Well, I think I would like to be in Bell, Colorado with Richard Gere.
Mr. Ham.
Louisville, Kentucky. I really would. I'd rather be in Louisville, Kentucky.
Somewhere studying for my exams, because they are really important. You know, you got to concentrate on your exams.
My name is Lisa Cox, and I would like to welcome all of you to the Miss Western pageant.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Western 1990-91, Cheryl Hayward.
The 1990-91 Western High School Band is a hard-working, dedicated team that doesn't quit until they get it right and are not afraid of the hard work needed to achieve their goals.
Right after school is when Video Ovation is able to catch the band practicing. No matter how hot or how cold, the band is always working hard, outside or inside.
And the freshmen just went right to work, and the upperclassmen, you know, let them know right off the bat what they expected, and they just gelled. And the whole band, everybody likes each other, and they're getting along. And they, you know, when we go out to a contest, they've got one thing in mind, and that's to win, and or to do the very, very best that they can.
What's your most memorable moment in band?
That would probably be my freshman year when we went to Bluestone. We took everything. I mean, it was just so exciting, and everybody really worked hard and everything, and it really floored me.
When me and Angie Hudson broke a window on the senior bus.
Probably the first time I was ever in an actual competition.
Time we went to Philadelphia and got caught with two girls in the room.
My hats are off to these young people. Even though these bands were older, more mature, and more experienced, they were not going to be denied. They said it before they went in, and they said it when they came out. My hats are off to them. I'm very, very proud of them.
Thank you.
But among the cheers, there were also tears.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's
he's been over there since August 11th. He just got married in July. And we just pray for him, and he just, I said, all he can do is wait and hope. And we pray that you'll pray for him and just hope he has a safe return home. Thank you for everything.
Christy Leaf already has one brother stationed in the Gulf, and another one left early this morning. But she says this gathering is helping her make it through a difficult day.
He loves his country, and he loves his family. And he doesn't love what he's doing, but he's doing what he's got to do. And he is in contact with us, and we appreciate what all of you have done for him today.
One by one, family members who have loved ones in the Gulf came forward to accept a box full of remembrances and supplies. The students collected these items for each of the 23 servicemen who were at one time students at the school. Along with the goodies, an album was included, full of high school memories and letters from friends. Janice Billings knows her brother will appreciate the gifts.
There was a few students in our school that made like the regional team for football, and he was happy to hear about those people, and he knows them.
I don't think this war is a good thing because people have family to be with, and the reason I say this is because my father's over there in Saudi Arabia. And it makes me feel bad.
Since we're in the war now, I hope and pray that we do win and that our troops will be home safely.
With the idea of our Constitution, I feel that we should then help other people that have had their rights taken away. And I think Hussein's invasion into Kuwait has done such that.
Like many communities across the nation, the Gulf War is hitting close to home. And folks here think the good thing about communities like this one is that its members rally around those who are hurting, lend a helping hand of support.
It feels really good because people are always asking me about them, and it lets me know they care about me and my family, and also my brother especially. It helps a lot.
Some of the soldiers honored today graduated from Western Alamance as long as 10 years ago. Others have only been out of school for a couple of years.
Students here start their day with war updates, but the ones in Mrs. Bass's English class do more than watch. They write, too. Dozens of letters to American troops who graduated from their high school.
We're in sixth period now watching TV.
We're watching you over there kicking their tails.
What all is going on there? They don't show much here on TV.
I'm sorry that there's war. Maybe it's for the best. I would rather have you all here with me than over there fighting for us.
Both my parents are in the Air Force. My dad just got back from over there.
Things are really crazy around here. Most people don't understand what's going on over there.
Atlantis and the Gamma Ray Observatory.
The fire is only 20% contained.
To the top I keep on climbing.
Cincinnati, the champions of baseball. Ah!
We got the break, just to break it today.
And I'm the one again.
Duke has won its first national championship.
A unified Germany.
Bluntly resigned.
Dad, I'm not getting racy. I've been racy.
Not guilty of obscenity.
I will welcome full investigation.
Saddam is making the mistake of his life. They are hostages, and the whole world knows it.
We want peace!
Just 2 hours ago, Allied Air Forces began an attack.
Scott's come again.
Everybody in it is either wounded or dead.
We were the thunder and lightning of Desert Storm.
It's either them or me.
Copy. Check.
Take out that time.
Aggression is defeated. The war is over.
Oh,
goodbye.
Yes.
Goodbye to Miss Pernell. She's so sweet. And to Heather Dew here and Christine.
My advice to underclassmen is stay out of trouble and take regular English.
Yeah, I'd rather go to Western than any other because we have so many freedoms, and that's because we're a well-disciplined school. And I think that that's going to help me a lot along the way.
My favorite year at Western was my senior year because I got to leave at 11 o'clock. And my friend Tammy is who I'm going to miss the most.
Yeah, I like my time with my best friend, Kelly. We've had some really meaningful moments together here at Western High School, and I'll never forget them.
Oh, who I miss the most be my homeboy right here.
Oh, don't even say me then.
Come on, girl.
We just want everybody to remember our fun time.
I like to say farewell to all my good friends that I've made, some I've lost, and some that I've gained.
Yay! I'm really going to miss Gray's dreams and all the wonderful things she had to say about me.
Just say bye.
Bye.
Congratulate you and extend my appreciation for all that you have done to help these young people make it to this stage in their life.
The basics of a successful school include love, kindness, understanding, recognition, and individualism.
Friends, this will be our final farewell. It is time for us to follow the path.